Hi, so how are you all doing? Generally, I do not make videos for engineering or medical aspirants. I mostly focus on, you know, the research scholars and people who want to pursue research. Because I myself, who am I? Let me tell you, I am Vivek Dwivedi. I am pursuing integrated MSc in chemistry. I am currently in fourth year at NISER Bhubaneswar. NISER is National Institute of Science Education and Research. It is one of the best institute in the country to pursue research. But the reason for me making this video is to address this really important problem which right now is happening. You know, because the JEE mains exam has happened, the advanced exam is yet to happen, NEET has happened, and NEST exam has happened, and IIT exams have happened. So all these exams have happened, but the results are delayed. Some of the results have came, and you know, the counseling process is really delayed. And this time the NISER counseling has started before any other exam counseling. So what is happening right now is that a lot of students whose priority is, you know, either engineering or medical are coming to NISER. I do not know what they are thinking if it is not their priority. If it is not your priority to do research, I think it is really not a good idea. Now, again telling you further, I want to give you a small disclaimer that please note, in this video I am going to tell my honest views being a research student at NISER, and I know what is the scenario at NISER, what is the situation of any research college in India, how much hard work it takes. If you think, you know, that you didn't get engineering and you can just come to NISER as a backup plan and, you know, you can grow here, it is going to be hard. It is going to be really, really hard. I am being very honest with you. So the disclaimer is that please note, whether you take seat in any college or not, it is totally your views. It should be totally your decision. Here, all I am, the purpose of this video, all I want to do is to make you aware of various things and personally share my views. Whether you take decision or take a seat or not, it is totally up to you. Please do not get influenced by this video. Now, let me tell you certain things which I really wanted to tell you. First point is, I already told you who am I to tell you all these things, right? Who am I to tell you the things about engineering versus research? So I am a research student at NISER in fourth year. So I have experience of fourth year. There are total 5 year course. So after fifth year, I'll be graduating. So I have a pretty much experience which I can tell you. Second thing, that problem is that if you are having the priority as engineering or medical, but you know, if you're just taking up the seats, first of all, you're wasting seat thinking that later if you get seat at engineering, any engineering college, IIT, NIT or whatever, or if you get seat at some medical colleges, you will just leave NISER. So first of all, that is a very bad thing to do, and NISER is very strict about it. It is not good thing at all, because you're wasting first of all a lot of seat, and second thing, you're paying fees and all those things, that is secondary. Yeah, you're paying about 20,000, it's fine. More importantly, now there is COVID. So even if earlier people were, you know, anyhow they used to leave the seat, now there is COVID, there is entry protocol at the gate. Even if you want to leave NISER, it is going to be very hard. So please take this decision carefully. This is the decision for your life. So therefore, I want to make this video that this is a very important decision which college you're joining after 12th, right? So it will not be very easy, you know, to just leave NISER after you get some medical or engineering seats. So decide properly. Do not waste seat first of all. And if you really want to come to NISER, fine, fine. But if you are filling the seats and, you know, taking up the seats thinking that, okay, you will, if you get engineering or medical colleges, then you will leave NISER. That is not going to be so easy at all. First of all, the NISER classes are starting soon. All the students, they are going to finish counseling really fast. Students are being called from 4th of October to 8th of October. They will call you. They will put you in quarantine for about 10 days at least. After quarantine, you know, you will have to buy a lot of things. You will have to settle down. You will have to buy mattresses. You will have to buy various things. You will have to start attending classes after that. And I don't think it is going to be easy at all, you know, to leave the seat at NISER. So just think, you are stuck there for 5 years then. And let me tell you what after that. Please note, in any career, it is not going to be easy if you're not interested in that career. For example, if you're a math student, can you really study biology? How easy is it to study biology? Similarly, if you're a bio student, can you really study mathematics? No, right? But at NISER, the research is interdisciplinary. You will have to study bio and maths both for first year. even later also you will need the knowledge of biology, of mathematics, even if you are in bio or maths. So please take this decision carefully. Do not just take the seat thinking that okay, right now the counseling for other colleges have not happened, so I can take neither. That is one thing. Second thing, that at academics, I want really all of you to, you know, see my video why you should not come to NYSER and why you should come to NYSER. I have covered in detail. Those videos are not so good in quality because those were the first videos I made, so I was not so experienced with YouTube. But please watch those videos. They are totally honest videos. I have told that what are the factors you must consider and not come to NYSER if you think that, you know, you will easily get a job after NYSER or other things. So it is going to be hard. Research is very hard, and almost anything which is important in life and very valuable is hard. Medical is also hard. Engineering is also hard. A lot of things is hard. Now the choice is that which hard you want to pick. Most of the times what happens is that after research at NYSER, after BSc, MSc, a lot of people from NYSER mostly do PhD, and PhD generally takes on an average 5 years. In India it can go up to 7 years, in US generally 5 years, in Europe around 3 years. In various countries it differs, and it also differs based on the topic you're working on, the project work, your guide, your own capability. So you'll have to spend a lot of time in labs doing the experiments, and if you're not interested in science, you are going to hate it, and this can turn out to be the worst decision of your life. So please do not make this mistake of, you know, choosing NYSER if you do not want to pursue research. It is almost like taking the medicine for cancer when you all you need is paracetamol, for example. It's a really bad example, but that is what it is. If you really need engineering or medical degrees and you are pursuing research, that is blunder, a big mistake. Because if you want to thrive in any of the career, you need to work really hard for at least 5-10 years, be it medical, be it science. For example, in engineering, you need to do B-Tech, right? And then you have a lot of chances of getting job after B-Tech. But it is not so easy after MSc at NYSER. I have made career videos on NYSER. You can check it out and you will see. A lot of people do PhD. So finally, if I want to conclude, that make sure that what you have studied in class 11, 12th and what you were reading till now, you know, various theory about science, all of you will need to, you know, do an experiment with all these things. You'll have to spend at least 2-3 hours. What is 2-3 hours? Like in 4th and 5th year, you will have to study and spend about 6-7 hours in the lab, okay? If you really want to do good research, whether it is computational, theoretical or experimental lab. So just imagine you will have to spend 6-7 hours in the lab in 4th, 5th year. At least 3 hours in 2nd and 3rd year. At least 3 hours in 1st year. From 1st year itself, you will have at least 3 hours of lab. So if you cannot, you know, just struggle with all these things, if you cannot do all of these things, if you cannot study more of what you have already been studied, if your passion is towards engineering and technical degrees, if your passion is towards medical, please do not waste your life and come to NYSER. I know a lot of students who are right now at NYSER, and I know they are doing really terrible. They are doing really, really terrible, and they are struggling really bad at NYSER. It is very hard to score if you are not interested in research. It is very hard to study. So if you are not studying, how will you get good marks at NYSER? If you do not get good marks, your scholarship will stop and a lot of things will follow up to you. So if you're not getting good marks, because this field is basically academia, the academics, right? So basically, if you're not getting good marks, you will have to face a lot of challenges. And why you might not get good marks is because you might not like studying. As I told you, if you do not like studying, please do not come to NYSER. So that was what I wanted to tell you all. A lot of people are approaching me how to withdraw the admission. All you can do is just mail the email given in the website with the details which they are asking, like your name, your roll number and all those things. I'll give the link of website in the description. So I hope this video was useful. It was an honest opinion. Please decide for yourself. Do not go what I'm telling you. Please think for yourself. It is your life, your decision. With that, all the best. Bye bye.